So we're in the 10th year of Thriller Fest.
Wow.
How does it feel? You've been here the whole time, right?
I've been here the whole time.
How is it like?
The growth. The first thing I think about it is how much bigger we are.
Yeah.
How many more? I call them freshmen. That's the authors who come in for Pitch Fest and Craft Fest, trying to to rise up. And here's what I'd say about our 10th year. Here's what I'd say about where we are. This organization was founded on a principle, our mission statement, of the haves reaching down to the not yet haves. I won't call them have-nots. Well, everything in principle and theory is fine, but let's put it into practice. And we have exceeded that mission statement. We have gone beyond that philosophy, because it's not just a philosophy that created International Thriller Writers. It's a state of mind, a state of being, and the camaraderie. And it's a wonderful network. I don't know if there's another industry where the stars, the Lee Childs and the David Morells and the R.L. Steins and the Steve Berries, and there's so many more. I could go on forever. The Lisa Gardners, the Sandra Browns, do everything they can to help authors get to not maybe that level, but get into the industry. By helping critique manuscripts, by mentoring, by our debut author program, by providing blurbs, which are the gold standard in the business, by being role models. And I think that is the most important thing. Because the process is useless if the people coming up don't do the same thing for those that then are below them. It's got to be a self-perpetuating philosophy. Mm-hmm. It's got to be a state of being and in order to make it work.
Yeah. No, it really is amazing because, I'm also an actress, and there's certainly nothing like that for my industry.
I'm going to tell you, I just did another interview where I talked about my experience as a screenwriter and doing film, trying to do film, failing miserably at times. And I said, well, I don't think you see Brad Pitt helping young actors the way Lee Child helps writers. There is a celebrity factor there, but there's also actors are rampantly insecure. Even the best ones, a lot of them won't watch themselves on film.
Yeah.
They don't seem to enjoy the finished product the way authors engage in the finished product. And the exception to that is a literary actor, I would call. That's what I would call George Clooney. Because George Clooney is about the whole package. So he's choosing the films, he's producing the films, he's taking chances with movies like The Descendants, movies like the Edward R. Murrow story he did, Good Night and Good Luck. Mm-hmm. And I think that kind of vision is what the book industry to a great extent still has.
Yeah.
But the film industry is about sequels, comic books, franchises, and cartoons. Nobody wants to do anything daring or original, or it's not material based. It's package based.
Mm-hmm.
Here, as you heard Jonathan Karp, the publisher of Simon Schuster, just say to 400 people, it's all about the material. Nothing else. It's not about the campaign. The campaign exists because of the material.
Right.
And I think the difference between the book business and the film business is just that. And it's just interesting to me, and this is a fascinating thing, that when I grew up, film was the gold standard. The Godfather, Chinatown, Dirty Harry, The Wild Bunch, Deliverance. The best writing was John Milius' Apocalypse Now. Mm-hmm. The Coppola, writing, The Godfather. Oh, I forgot. And Puzo wrote it with him. Now, nobody thinks of great writing on film. They think of great writing on TV. And what do they say about shows like Breaking Bad, Mad Men, Fargo, which just ran on FX, Ray Donovan? What do they say about these high-end literary shows? They're like novels.
Yeah.
You know what? And maybe, maybe Hollywood needs to learn from television. What's the difference? The difference, Jessica, is that in Hollywood, the business people control everything.
Mm-hmm.
In television, the creative people are in control. So it's much more like the book business.
Yeah.
And I know the models don't work, and I know it's all about money, and I know it's all about corporate. But to me, the thing in that we stress in when we're talking about in the craft of writing is it all starts with the book. It all starts, you write the best book you can, and you don't need to think about putting an actor in it, getting a director, and figuring out what the below the line and where we're going to shoot the movie for the least amount of money. You don't have to do any of that. Mm-hmm. So it's interesting to see paradigm shifts happen, and in some respects to know people who were part of them. You know, and it's the great, because, you know, the great thing about this organization is we root for each other.
Yeah, no, really.
I mean, when Lee Child's movie got made, finally, Jack Reacher, mm-hmm. and made very well, I might add.
Yeah.
I love that movie. Now they're doing a sequel, mm-hmm. Never Go Back. Maybe I'm not supposed to say that, but I just did. It doesn't matter. And we're all so, everyone's so happy for Lee. No one's mm-hmm. jealous. No one, you know, it's a wonderful thing when your friends do well.
Yeah. That's great. And now, speaking of doing well, you have a book coming out soon, a new book, September, you said.
I'll tell you, I'm very excited. It's Caitlin Strong, number 6. And here's the thing about writing a book. Mm-hmm. You ain't got no idea what you got until the galleys go out and you start hearing back from people who review you all the time, read you all the time, and who have something, a frame of reference to compare it to. I've now heard from 4 people that I trust as much as I trust anyone in the business who've all said this is the best book I've ever done. Now, I can't tell you I thought that myself, because you love all your books like your children equally.
Right.
Because you don't know how all, what an author does is fit the pieces. The job of the author is to take all these disparate pieces mm-hmm. and somehow in a thriller, that's the quest story, mm-hmm. is fit the pieces together. And you never know how the pieces fit together in their entirety until the book is out or at least finished and in print form. And people start giving you some evaluations and they start telling you why it's the best one. So this is the 6th book in the Caitlin Strong series, Strong Darkness. And it seems like after 6 books, you know, maybe I'm finally figuring it out. But the last one, Strong Rain Falling, won 2 major awards.
Oh, great.
USA Book Mystery Suspense of the Year and International Book Award Mystery Suspense of the Year. Caitlin's getting her recognition, mm-hmm. and I hope some better sales will follow.
Yeah. Oh, well, good luck with the new book.
Thank you.
September 30th, you said?
September 30th, so it's an October book, mm-hmm. but it'll be in stores. The laydown date. I don't know why they have to have a laydown date for me. It's not like I'm J.K. Rowling, you know. But yeah, they'll go on sale on that. I think it's a Tuesday. They're all books are released on Tuesdays. It's a happy day.
Oh, cool! Well, I can't wait to read it.
Thank you.